Hello students, we are doing chapter number 1 integers and today we will discuss exercise 1.3. In this exercise we have to do the multiplication of integer. So first we will discuss rules for the multiplication of integer. First rule is when you are multiplying a positive integer with a positive integer. In that case you have to multiply both the integers and the symbol will come plus. For example, plus 3 multiplied by plus 2, then 3 into 2 will become 6 and plus into plus will become plus. Second rule, when one integer is positive and another integer is negative, then you have to do the product of these two integers and symbol will come minus, plus and minus will become minus. For example, plus 3 multiplied by minus 2. Then answer will be minus 6. Plus and minus will become minus. 3 into 2 will become 6. It may be the negative integer at first place. We can take similar example, minus 3 into plus 2. In this, minus integer is at first place and positive at second place. So in this one also you have to use the same rule. Minus into plus will become minus and then 3 into 2 will become 6. Third rule, when both the integers are negative, negative integer multiply by negative integer. In that case, minus and minus will become plus and then you have to multiply these two integers. For example, minus 3 multiply by minus 2 is equal to plus 6. 2 times minus symbol will become plus. After rules of multiplication of integer, we have properties of multiplication of integer. First property is closure property. According to this property, if you have two integers, A and B belongs to I, it means A and B are two integers, then their product also will be an integer. Let us take one example. Suppose we have 2 and minus 3, two integers are there. And if we multiply 2 into minus 3, answer is coming minus 6, and which is also a integer. Second property is commutative property. According to this property, if we have two integers, then the multiplication order doesn't matter. If you multiply A to B or B to A, in both the way answer will come same. You can see here with the help of this example, 2 and minus 3, two integers are there. If we multiply 2 into minus 3, answer is coming 6. And if we multiply minus 3 into 2, in that case also answer is coming minus 6. It means in multiplication, order doesn't matter. Third property is associative property. In this property, we have 3 integers and we will change the order of multiplication. It means first we are multiplying these last two and the result will multiply with first one. Then answer will be equal to the product of first two with the third one. It means if you have 3 integer, 4 integer, then also order doesn't matter. You can see with the help of this example, 2, minus 3 and 4. 3 integers are there. So first I multiplied these two last two, minus 3 into 4 will become minus 12, minus 12 into 2 minus 24. Now we will change the order. First we will multiply first two, 2 into minus 3 is minus 6 and minus 6 into 4 minus 24. So in both the way answer is coming same. Next rule, we have distributive property over addition and subtraction. According to this property, if we have 3 integers, then A multiply by B plus C will be equal to A multiply by B. Means this A first we have to multiply with B, then plus, and this A we have to multiply with C. Same thing we can do for subtraction also. For subtraction, first we have to multiply A with B, then minus symbol and A with C. We have to expand it. We will take one example. Suppose if you have 2, minus 3, 4, 3 integers are there, then 2 into minus 3 plus 4. If you calculate this left side, you will get minus 3 plus 4 is 1, 2 into 1, 2. And if you take this right side, 2 into minus 3, 2 into minus 3, first multiply this number with the first integer, then this symbol, plus symbol, then 2 into 4. So 2 into minus 3, minus 6, 2 into 4, 8. So minus 6 plus 8 is equal to 2. So in both the way, you will get the same answer. Same thing we can do for subtraction also. After this, next we have existence of multiplicative identity. It means a number which we will multiply with any integer, but answer will not change. So here one is that integer. If we multiply one with any integer, answer will be same. Now we will start exercise 1.3. First question is find the product. Product means you have to multiply these numbers. So first is 7 into minus 35. 7 is not having any symbol here, it means 7 is having plus. So plus into minus will be minus, so symbol will come minus here. Next is 7 into 35, multiply, you will get 245. Second one, minus 13 into minus 15. So minus into minus, symbol will become plus, and 13 into 15 will become 195. Third one, minus 12 into minus 11 into minus 10. So first two minus will become plus and third minus will be as it is. So the final symbol will be minus. 12 into 11, 132, and 132 into 10, 1320. Fourth one, in fourth one you can see here, this minus minus will become plus, but you can see here we have middle term 0 here. This middle number is 0. So if we multiply anything with 0, then answer will be 0. So here directly we can write 0. No need to multiply these two number also. Next, minus 1 into minus 2 into minus 3 into 4. So minus into minus will become plus and third minus will be as it is. So answer will be in minus, then 1 into 2, 2, 2 into 3, 6, 6 into 4, 24. So answer will be minus 24. Next we have minus 3 into minus 6 into minus 2 into minus 1. So 4 times minus we have. These two minus will become plus. These two minus also will become plus. Remaining number we have to multiply. 3 into 6, 18. 18 into 2, 36. And 36 into 1, 36. So answer will be plus 36. Mentioning this plus symbol is not necessary. If you put plus symbol or not, no problem. Question number 2, verify the following. In this type of question, you have to verify left side is equal to right side. So the side before this equal to symbol we will call left side, and another side of equal to we will call right side. So both the side we have to find out, and then we have to check whether answer is coming same or not. So first we will take left side. 37 into 6 plus minus 3. So 37 into 6 plus and minus will become minus, 6 minus 3. 37 into 6 minus 3 is 3. 37 into 3 will be 111. So we got left side. Now we will calculate right side. 37 into 6 plus 37 into minus 3. First multiply 37 into 6, 222. And 37 into minus 3 will be minus 111. So after subtraction you will get minus plus 111. So you can see left side and right side both are coming same. So left side is equal to right side, and same thing only we have to verify, hence verified. If your both the sides are not coming same, it means you have to recheck again your calculation. Second part, same thing we have to do. We have to verify left side is equal to right side. So first we will take left side. -21 multiply by -6 plus -4. -21 multiply by -6 -4. This plus and minus will become minus. Then -21 multiply by -10. -6 and -4 both are minus. It means we have to add. So 6 plus 4 is 10, but symbol will come minus. So -21 into -10 will be plus 210. We got left side. Now same thing do for right side also. -21 into -6 plus -21 into -4. So -21 and -6, if you multiply, you will get plus 126. And here also minus and minus will become plus. 21 into 4 will be 84. If you add these two numbers, then you will get 210. So you can see left side and right side is coming same, because left side is equal to right hand side, hence verified. Next question number 3, using suitable properties evaluate the following. So first part is given 8 into 53 into -125. Whatever the properties I have explained you before this chapter, that we have to use here. So here you can see three numbers we are multiplying. We have to see how we will multiply, our calculation will become easy. So first, if we multiply this first and last one, 8 into -125, if you multiply these two, you will get -1000, and this 53 is as it is. Now you can see 1000 become an easy number. It's very easy to multiply these two. We can write it 1000 into 53 will be 53,000. Second part, -8 into -2 into -3 into -5. So in this also we will change the order of multiplication. We will not multiply in the same order. Wherever you will see 5, multiply with some even number. You can see here 2 is there. If you multiply 2 and 5, answer will become 10. So we will multiply these two number and these two number together. So 8 into 3 will be 24, because it is minus and this one is plus, so finally it will be -24. And -2 into -5, minus and minus will become plus. 2 into 5 is 10. Now -24 into 10, so it will be -240. Next, third part, -6 into 2 into -8 into -5. So in this also 2 and 5 is there. If you will have 2 and 5, immediately multiply the two number. So these two we have to multiply and these two first step. So -6 into -8 will become plus 48. 2 into 5 will become 10. Then 48 into 10 will be 480. Fourth part, 15 into -25 into -4 into 10. If in a question you have 25 and -4, so first multiply 25 and 4, because you will get here 100 and it will become very easy. So first these two number if you multiply, minus into minus will be plus. 25 into 4 will become 100 and this is 10. So 15 into 100 into 10 will be 15,000. Next example, 26 into -48 plus -48 into -36. So in this question we will use distributive property over addition. If a into b plus a into c is there, then we can write it as a into b plus c. So here also you can see a into b, okay, then sorry, you can take A this one, A into B, then A into C. So this -48 is common in both the terms. So this -48 we can take as common. -48 if we took out, then what we will be having from this first term 26, this plus symbol, and then second term is -36. Then -48, simplify whatever is inside the bracket, 26 minus 36, plus and minus will become minus. -48 into -10. Now multiply these two, minus and minus will become plus, 48 into 10 will be 480. Sixth part, 724 multiply by minus 56 plus 7 minus 724 multiply by 44. So here also we will use the same property, distributive property over addition. But you can see here 724 is there in both the term, but one first one is having plus symbol, second one is having minus symbol. So first we have to make these symbols same. So what we can do, 724 into minus 56. This minus symbol we can take with the second number. So we can write it as 724 into minus 44. Because multiplication order doesn't matter, so this minus is here or here, no problem, answer will come same. Now you can see this minus 724, minus 724 is there in both the terms. So take 724 common. After that we have from first term minus 56. And from second term minus 44. Now simplify within this bracket, minus 56 plus and minus will become minus, minus 44. These both the numbers are having minus symbol, it means we have to add it and symbol will come minus. So 724 into minus 100. So now we can multiply. 724 is having plus symbol, this is having minus symbol, so final symbol will be minus 72400. Next is seventh part, minus 47 into 102. In this case we should not multiply directly, we have to use here some property. Same property we are going to use here but in reverse way. So here this minus 47 we can keep as it is and we will see which number we can split as in tens or hundreds. So this 102 we can write 100 plus 2. Always choose the easy number. If 47 you will split, you will get 40 plus 7 or 50 minus 3. So that both the numbers are difficult, better you split this 102, then 102, both numbers are very easy for multiplication. Now first minus 47 we will multiply with the first number 100, then the symbol, plus symbol, and minus 47 we will multiply with the second number. So minus 47 into 100 plus minus 47 into 2. Minus 47 into 100 will be minus 4700, and minus 47 into 2 will be minus 94. Then minus 4700, this will be minus. Both are minus, it means you have to add minus 4794 is answer. Next to minus 39 into minus 97. So here also we have to use same property, distributive property. So in this case we will split this 97, minus 97. We can write it as minus 100 plus 3. Because we want answer in year minus 97, so 100 will be having minus symbol. So minus 100 plus 3, which is equal to minus 97. Now we will use the property, minus 39 into minus 100, then this symbol plus symbol, minus 39 into second number. So first this number multiply with the first number, then this middle symbol, first number with the second number. So minus 39 into minus 100, minus minus will become plus, then you will get 3900. This plus and minus will become minus, and 39 into 3 will be 117. Now subtract these two number. We will get 3783. Next question number 4. You have to do here fill up. So first part minus 4 into dash is equal to 44. So with minus 4 we have to multiply one number. Answer should come 44. So if you see the 4 table, 11 times 44 will come. It means here we have to fill 11. Next we will see the symbol. Final symbol is here plus. We don't have any symbol here. It means plus is there. Here one minus is there. So to make it plus, it means we want one more minus. So in this fill up, minus 11 will come. Second one, 7 into dash is equal to minus 42. In 7 table, if you see, 6 times minus 42 will come. So 7, 6 are 42. But we want minus 42. It means 6 is having minus symbol. Same here. Dash multiply by minus 13 is equal to 143. So 11 times we have to multiply here, and this is minus. We want final answer in plus. It means one more minus is required. This 11 is having minus symbol. Next fourth one, minus 5 into dash is equal to 0. We will use here property of 0. If we multiply any number with 0, then only answer will come 0. For this third one, if you have very big number and you are not able to do directly, then you can do in another way also. Suppose here we don't know which number will come. So we have taken a into minus 13 is equal to 143. Now this minus 13 is here in multiplication with a. If you shift another side, then it will go for division. So 143 divided by minus 13. So when you do the division, then you will get answer minus 11. So like this also you can simplify these questions. Question number 5. A certain freezing process required that room temperature be lowered from 32 degree at the rate of 5 degree every hour. What will be the room temperature 8 hour after the freezing process begin? So according to this question, initially the temperature is 32 degree centigrade and after 1 hour it will reduce 5 degree. Now we have to find out after 8 hour what will be the temperature. So in question it is given initial temperature is given 32 degree centigrade. Temperature decrease every hour, decrease in 1 hour will be 5 degree centigrade. Now we have to check in 8 hour. Temperature decreased in 8 hours will be 5 into 8, 40 degree centigrade. So 40 degree centigrade temperature will decrease within 8 hour. So final temperature will be 32 degree and decrease means we have to put minus symbol. How much it has decreased? 42 degree centigrade. So 32 minus 40 is minus 8 degree centigrade. So after 8 hour the temperature of room will be minus 8 degree centigrade. Question number 6. In a class test containing 10 questions, 5 marks are awarded for correct answer and 2 marks are deducted for every incorrect answer and 0 marks for not attempting any question. So first part is Rohit gets 4 correct and 6 incorrect. We have to find out his final score. So in this question, Rohit has done 4 correct. So marks for correct answer he has done 4 correct and for each mark, each question he is getting 5 marks. So total will be 20 marks he will get, plus 20 we can write here. Plus 20 marks for the correct answer. Now marks for incorrect answers. He has done 6 incorrect answers, and for each incorrect deduction is -2 marks. Deduction means minus symbol. So for every wrong answer we have to put -2. 6 he has done wrong, so it means total will be -12. So his score will be +20 he got for correct one and -12 he got for wrong one. So +20 -12, it means his score is +8 marks. Second part, Seema gets 5 correct and 5 incorrect answers. What is her score? So marks for 5 correct answers. She has done 5 correctly and for each one she is getting 5 marks. So 5 into 5 plus 25 marks she is getting for correct answers. Now marks for incorrect answers. She has done 5 incorrect and for each incorrect we have to deduct -2. So 5 into -2, -10. So her score will be +25 -10, which will be +15 marks. Third part, Ritu attempted 7 questions and gets only 2 correct answers. What is her score? So total she has attempted 7 questions out of 10, it means 3 questions she left. From these 7 also only 2 are correct. So correct answers are and incorrect answers are. Total she has done 7, from 7 2 are correct, so it means 5 are incorrect and 3 she left. Now marks for correct answers. Two questions she has done correct and for each question she is getting 5 marks, it means +10. Now marks for wrong answers. She has done 5 wrong and for each one we have to deduct 2. So 5 into -2, -10. And marks for leftover questions. This is not compulsory to write also, you can leave also. 3 into 0, 0. So her final score will be, she got +10 for correct one, -10 for wrong one and 0 for not attempted. So +10 and -10 will become 0, it means she got 0 more marks. Hope you understood this exercise. Practice yourself also these questions. Thank you for watching our video.